On this special build edition of the AI Show, join us as we hear from Joy Kiao, AI architect, and Mario Inchiosa, principal software engineer at Microsoft, plus the data science team at Ernst & Young, or EY. Joy and Mario will chat with EY and discuss how they're using Fairlearn in practice. It's fascinating. Make sure you take a look.
Hi, my name is Mario Inchiosa, a data scientist here at Microsoft.
Hi, my name is Joy Tiao. I'm an AI solution architect here at Microsoft. We're members of the Azure AI Platform Customer Engineering Team, where we help our customers and partners to build AI products and services on Azure.
Today, we're joined by Microsoft partner EY to talk about how EY is using Microsoft's machine learning fairness toolkit, Fairlearn, to assess the fairness of their credit adjudication model and mitigate any fairness issues. Fairlearn is an open source Python package and GitHub repo created by Microsoft Research and the Azure AI Platform team. You can learn more about Fairlearn by watching Manush Samecki's on-demand build video entitled How to Test Models for Fairness with Fairlearn Deep Dive. Now we would like to welcome our EY partners to the conversation. Mario, Jason, William, and Alex, would you please introduce yourselves?
Hello, my name is Mario Schlener. I'm a Toronto-based partner for EY, and I lead our risk management practice for EY in Canada nationally.
Hello, my name is Jason Chua. I'm working in Mario's team. I'm currently leading a few AI use machine learning use cases, including model development, validation, and model risk governance.
Hello, my name is William Chen. I'm a senior in Mario's team. I work extensively in financial risk modeling and model validation, as well as advanced analytics machine learning modeling.
Hi, my name is Alex Mohalska. I'm a partner based out of Toronto, and I am responsible for data, AI, and analytics nationally in Canada.
Thank you. It's great to have you all here. Start off, Mario, could you please tell us about EY's trusted AI platform?
Our trusted AI platform has three key components that we would like to cover as a solution offering for the industries. One is part of the development cycle, part of the audit and the assessment of AI algorithms that are in use, and a third component, which is the overall AI governance component. All of these three components are part of our AI trusted lifecycle, and we currently, as EY, we have invested in creating a platform which provides an end-to-end solution.
Thanks, Mario. Now I'll turn it over to my teammate Joy for the rest of the questions.
Thank you. Thank you for that introduction. Now, can you describe the specific use case you had and where the consideration of fairness came in?
Sure, I'll take this one. So through the collaboration with the Microsoft research team, the use cases we selected for model fairness detection and remediation is the retail clients adjudication model for a large Canadian bank. This is classification model. So the goal is actually we need to differentiate good clients and bad clients depending on the likelihood of default. So this is a fundamental model for the bank for utilized for the bank onboarding adjudication strategy. So they need to select the good clients to extend loan or mortgage. So from model performance perspective, yes, we leverage lots of advanced machine learning techniques to improve the model performance, such as AUC F1 score. In the meanwhile, fairness is also very important, not only for the asset consideration and also for the regulatory consideration and also bank's reputation risk. So in particular, for these use cases, we leverage the Microsoft Fairlearn tools to how to define our fairness principles and how to detect the unfairness issues in the model development process. And also in the end, we come up with the right approach to remediate the unfairness issues throughout the model development and also post-model development, the whole journey of the development process.
Thank you, Jason. That makes a lot of sense. Now, could you walk us through how you used Fairlearn to assess and mitigate the observed unfairness?
Absolutely, I will take this question. So throughout the modeling process, UI and Microsoft research team have closely collaborated to enhance the user experience of the Fairlearn package. So first step of solving the problem of fairness is actually to know the problem. So facilitated by the dashboard function of the Fairlearn package, we were able to easily evaluate and visualize the fairness of model output with regard to the protect feature. In this case, is the gender, in terms of demographic parity and equalized odds. So knowing that fairness is indeed an issue with the model, the question now becomes how we want to remediate this problem. So a Fairlearn package provides the flexibility of remediating the unfairness both in training and post-training. And the user-friendly Fairlearn API allows users to quickly create multiple remediated models and visualize the trade-off between fairness and model accuracy, hence allowing a better informed business decision-making.
That's great. Thank you, William. So now, what do you see as the benefits of using Fairlearn in this particular use case? And also, do you think it will help UI's overall trusted AI platform and solution capabilities by incorporating Fairlearn as part of the model validation process?
Absolutely. I mean, the package, as it currently is set up, it provides a readily available tool with a variety of technical approaches. They can be selected based on the use case at hand and the unfair outcomes observed in the available data that we see. This was actually one of the major focus for the use case described by Jason and William to be able to identify and visualize easily the outcomes. And accordingly to the outcomes, we were able to interact with the pre-processed data or post-processed data in a way that we can actually remediate the unfairness in the overall model estimation.
Thank you, Mario. So as we are integrating Fairlearn as part of our overall Azure Machine Learning service, how do you envision moving forward with this offering? Like, how would the toolkit be incorporated in EY's machine learning lifecycle?
Yeah, Alex here, I'll take that question. So we see that, first of all, being able to explain models in terms of if they're fair or biased or not biased, and explainability in terms of transparency is a key differentiator in what we do. So in terms of our service offering, we see that incorporating Fairlearn is a call it business as usual aspect of how we will do modeling for any of our clients, whether that is in a regulatory environment or a non-regulatory environment. We see, generally speaking, that while there is a lot of interest in many open source libraries and the adoption of Python in the machine learning space, we do see a tremendous gap around the machine learning lifecycle, the operations, the so-called machine learning DevOps, the model management, as well as tying in all these aspects of fairness and bias detection. And we see that that Microsoft is uniquely positioned to lead in this area. And you know, our plans for the future is to adopt this and leverage this as part of our regular model lifecycle development that we perform for our clients.
Thank you so much. That's been very insightful. Thank you, everyone, for joining our conversation today. Really appreciate the close collaboration with UI on responsible AI.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're very welcome.
Thank you.